Hey guys, let's do a glowy holiday makeup look using Armani Luminous Silk Foundation. This is the industry's secret foundation. It is so good. I'm going in with the Luminous Silk Concealer to match. Some blush, some contour on the eyes, contour on the eyes. I put some mascara on. For my favorite part, which is lips, I'm using the Armani Lip Power in shade Eccentrico. It is so beautiful. Then I'm using the Fluid Sheer Highlighter, and this is the final look.
They are full up, so come now. So come now. They are come now.
White House and interviewed a politician I could only dream of interviewing. Like, I could only dream of interviewing. And I sat there. I was invited to the White House. I flew to DC to talk to this person. I just sat there and talked to them. I can't even sit still. But I have been educating young people on the news since I was 12. I started a political newsletter when I was a sixth grader, did it for 6.5 years, breaking down the news, then took to social media and started breaking down the news there. And like, look at where it's gotten me. 12-year-old me would be like shitting herself. Down the news for you, and you've given me a voice, and like, you've let this political girl in me, and I'm not gonna cry, you've let this like political girl in me flourish into the person it's always wanted to be. Did you know? Skincare edition. Skincare secret number one. I feel like a lot of people might know this, but if you don't, in the mornings I take like an ice cube, and when I feel puffy under my eyes, I just like roll ice cube over my eye, under my eyes, or like just on my face in general. Ice reduces puffiness. Obviously, sunscreen's really good for you. It's good for like anti-aging and whatever, and we should all be wearing sunscreen every day, but I didn't know this until just recently. Using a high SPF can actually increase product efficiency when you are dealing with breakouts. Number three, the golden number three, is these two ingredients called squalene and CBG. Squalene oil is plant-based and it's good for the environment, and it actually hydrates your skin without clogging your pores. CBG fights inflammation, and the two of those ingredients together is really good for breakouts. I use this every single day, morning and night. It has CBG and squalene. It's called Terasana Clear and Control Serum. This is what it looks like.
I am just having one of those days where just nothing is giving. Nothing about today is giving. Like, my hair is oily and I washed it yesterday. Why? Why? My skin is dry and I moisturized it. Why? Like, my clothes didn't fit right even though I put them on yesterday. Why? Why?
So let's do some self-care. You know, part of self-care is also just reaching out to your besties, right? Like, here's mine. Oh, look at us. And another is hanging out with your mama.
Hi, Kipster Moosh. Oh.
Obviously eat comfort food in the comfort of my bed and watch a TV show.
So I just took a shower because that always helps. Got out of the shower. Saw that the White House Chief of Staff followed me on all platforms. Very cool right now. So let's do my skincare routine. So we all just want clear and glowy skin, right? I've been talking about this for months. Terasana Clear and Control Serum. So it has CBG and squalane, which is why it's so good for my skin, because I have dry skin, but I also have acne, and it tackles both of those together. I'm gonna go read now. It has been a productive self-care afternoon. Student debt and systemic racism. Let's talk about it. Let's get real. The cost of accessing higher education in this country is so expensive, it is genuinely out of reach for most Americans unless they want to take on millions of dollars of student debt. To put that into perspective for you, nearly 50 million Americans carry $1.7 trillion of student debt. Debt is crushing, and more often than not, this reality falls on communities of color, particularly Black women. This is a direct result of systemic racism. Structural inequality and racism have created massive barriers in access to education. Most commonly, this would be seen as the likelihood to take on student loans, struggle with repayment, which is exacerbated by job discrimination and payment disparity. Racism is so deeply embedded in our educational and economic systems. As citizens of the United States, it is our duty and our responsibility to hold our elected officials accountable, and that's exactly what we're going to do. A petition in my bio that urges the Biden administration to cancel up to $50,000 in student debt per borrow by the end of 2021. But we need as many people as possible. Canceling student debt can help close the wealth gap by 20%, which is huge, and also secure the financial stability and economic mobility of Black, Latinx, and other people of color who are disproportionately burdened by loans, and addressing tons of other millions who struggle with debt. This is a common sense solution. Please sign the petition. News roundup of the week, let's start with Kyle Rittenhouse. So Kyle Rittenhouse was found not guilty on all charges related to a shooting of 3 people last year in an unsurprising but yet disturbing outcome that I think a lot of us suspected. Now, if you're ready to come at me and say, it was self-defense, you're so stupid, I don't care, and here's why. White supremacy is what brought Kyle to the streets that night. White supremacy is him being able to shoot 3 people, killing 2 of them in front of the police, and not even getting arrested nor apprehended. White supremacy is Kyle being offered internships by elected officials and being lauded as a hero before his trial was even over. Our legal and judicial systems were built on white supremacy meant to defend men like Kyle. So yes, this does have to do with race, and it does set a very dangerous precedent. Now on that note, let's move on to the Build Back Better Act. It was passed in the House, and now it awaits confirmation from the Senate. I'm not going to go too in-depth here because that's coming soon. The bill offers free universal pre-K for children ages 3 and 4. It offers a plan for more affordable childcare and an extension to the child tax credit, $550 billion investment into combating climate change, and an expansion of Medicare benefits, amongst a lot of other really great provisions. Let's talk about Julius Jones. I made a video on him a really, really long time ago, so this is really great news. He was on death row for like 19 years in Oklahoma, and 5 hours before his scheduled execution, he was actually granted clemency and had his sentence commuted. In the original trial, his alibi was never actually presented to the jury, that being he was at home with his family during the time of the murder, and he was convicted of the murder as the murderer. So you see where I'm going with this. And a lot of people don't think he did it, which is why there was a lot of pressure on the governor to commute his sentence.